it looks
right,
good.
Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're here at Salford City Boxing Academy today, and we've got Louis Fury with us. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you very much. How are you?
I'm really good, thanks, sir. It's good to see you sparring there. It's always fun to watch the big boy sparring. Tell us a little bit about your sparring partner. I've not met him before.
Yeah, he's a good kid. He's come down a few times. He's amateur. I think he'll do well in the amateurs. It's good to get all different types of lads, so getting good working.
Yeah, he's a young lad with a good engine, so you know it's good for him to sort of keep moving and working, isn't it?
It's a great experience for him. Yeah, it's good for learning curve for him.
Yeah. Just speaking to him there now, and you can't really buy that sort of experience sparring with someone like yourself.
Exactly, definitely you can't beat experience, and definitely coming into this. This part of the woods, it's different.
Yeah. And he's come down on his own as well, so that shows a lot of dedication.
No, 100%. Listen, you want to be anything in this sport, you've got to do. You've got to go spar the best, you've got to go to different places. You can't stay in the same one place and won't go anywhere. So, yeah, it's got a good head on his shoulders.
You've gone all over the place in your career as well, haven't you? Sort of sparring, travelling, learning your trade. I mean, what are some of the places that you've been to, sort of, you know, as you were coming through to learn your apprenticeship?
All over the world, literally. All over England, sparring, literally, all over different countries. So, yeah, I've had a great experience with that as well.
Yeah. And you did quite a lot of training out in France, I believe, as well, didn't you, when you were younger?
Yeah, we did. We travelled all around the world. Holland, France, Canada. We went to all Austria, everywhere sparring.
Would you sort of advise young fighters coming through to do that then, get as much international experience as you can in different locations?
Yeah, definitely. You need that sort of experience and that sort of world to see different fighters, to see different parts of the world and willing to go into different camps. So yeah, it's a great experience.
Yeah, great. Well, I'm glad to say we've got a fight date for you, and I've been looking out for this for a while, and it's great to see. So the 25th of next month, 25th of May, at Victoria Warehouse. Can you just tell us a little bit about how this sort of come about and the reasons for the choice of locations and everything like that?
Yeah, I've always wanted to keep fighting in my own town, Manchester, so thank God we finally got there. And now just waiting for an opponent, hopefully that'll be announced soon. And the 25th of May in Manchester, so it's a great date and a great fight date.
And it's at the Victoria Warehouse, which has kind of become a little bit like the York Hall of the North, to be honest. You've never fought there before, have you? But it's a great venue.
I haven't, but you know what it is? The crowd, like I say, it is. I've been there before. I've watched fighting there. The atmosphere there is unbelievable, and I can't wait for the same, because it's a great crowd as well.
Yeah. For people that have been asking me about sort of viewing the fight, can we just confirm that this is still on going to be live and free on Channel 5?
Yeah, it's going to be live and free on Channel 5, so a great channel, like always.
Yeah. No, it's brilliant to have that, because I remember when you fought Sam Sexton, the viewing figures were massive.
Yeah, it is. It's great to fight in Channel 5, especially you've got a different viewing public on there, and it's a nice thing, yeah.
Do you think there should be more sort of free boxing available for people to watch?
Yeah, I do, because not everyone has Sky and not everyone wants to pay for the fights and stuff, so it's nice to see other people, let's say older people, who don't have the Sky and that, they make them more keen and they love watching it. I remember after that fight, people coming up to me, people in their 80s, 90s, old people who was coming up, go on you, beeping the horns a lot, so it's nice to see a different people seeing it.
Yeah, that's a good point, that is. I mean, the terrestrial TV's got a lot more of a reach, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has, yeah.
Yeah. You mentioned that there's no sort of confirmed opponent yet, but that doesn't seem to sort of faze you. But how do you sort of prepare for an opponent that you don't know what their style's going to be like and things like that?
We spar anyone and anything, so it really doesn't really matter who it is, and we're bad anyway, so we just can't wait now to get in the ring.
There's some good young fighters coming through. Are you sort of in a stage now of your career where you're looking up and just looking for the big title fights, world title fights, or would you consider looking down as well in terms of some of the prospects coming through?
What it is with me is fights, whatever's fights on the table at the time. I'm not really bothered with fighting whatever else. So it's been the case with me, I'm always ready to fight whoever and get in the ring. So if all the fights make sense, then that's it. It makes sense.
Fair enough. Wonder if I could get your opinion and a little bit of a breakdown. You know, I know you're really good with sort of analysing fights. If Daniel Dubois and Joe Joyce do actually get the fight on, which is something that talking about at the minute, Joe Joyce just signed with Frank Warren, how do you see that fight going?
I can say it's going to be. It's rather explosive power and then power. So I reckon it's got to be. I reckon Joyce has got to keep his distance. I reckon he'd win by points or late knockout, or Daniel Dubois short. A short knockout.
So Dubois early or Joyce late?
Yeah.
In terms of your training partners, Owen, in terms of Savannah Marshall, is she going to be on the show as well?
Yeah, she's going to be on the show as well, ready to go as well, so I'm looking forward to seeing her back.
Brilliant. And Hennessy Sports have recently announced that they'll be taking Alex Dilmajani under their wing as well, who's a good featherweight prospect. So this car could have quite a lot of talent.
A lot of talent, 100%. I think it will do as well, so I'm looking forward to for the show.
Brilliant. And just finally then, some of the stuff that you've been working with your father, obviously you can't go into details, but are you always sort of evolving and trying and learning new different things?
Yeah, always listening to different spars, constantly we're doing, concentrating on one thing, so it makes more things more difficult to do, so it makes it hard, so we just got to keep doing it and keep doing it here, right.
Well, Yuri, thanks very much for your time. Really appreciate that. All the best in the final weeks of camp. And looking forward to fight night.
Thank you very much.
See you soon.
God bless you.
Cheers.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that video, leave your comments below. We love hearing your opinion. And also remember to hit that subscribe button. See you next time.